VIAVI COSA-4055 module, or COSA, is a CWDM analyzer module for the T-BERD or MTS 2000, 4000, or 5800 test set. The module is used to monitor a live CWDM network and display active wavelengths, channel spacing, and power levels. It can also measure wavelength drift and other statistics over time. In addition to the test port, the module has two integrated SFP slots. A CWDM optical transceiver may be connected to either or both SFP slots. Once inserted, the SFP is automatically activated for use as a CWDM light source. During turn-up or maintenance of a CWDM multiplexer, the COSA can be directly connected to the common port or common cable using an optical patch cable and coupler with connectors matching those of the COSA port and the fiber under test. The COSA can also be connected to the fiber under test via a monitor port or tap without disrupting service. In either case, all fibers and connectors should be inspected and clean prior to connection. I will now demonstrate how to use the COSA module. You can follow along on your own T-BERD or MTS 2000. After turning on the test set, press the home button to display the home screen and tap the COSA icon to launch the module. Press the setup button to configure your test settings. In the acquisition menu, select sweep and tap the test auto WDM soft key to load commonly used settings. Sweep will be set to single. It can optionally be set to continue to sweep continuously or to statistics or drift to measure statistics over time. The top menu soft key returns me to the main settings from where I can navigate to other settings. I'm going to leave analysis settings at the default values. If a splitter or tap is used to access the signal, you can set the splitter compensation value to the splitter loss in dB or percentage. I'm also going to leave the display settings at defaults with the exception of grid, which I will set to ITU CWDM. This allows me to optionally specify channel alarms. I'm going to leave link settings at defaults, but when you're in the field, you should specify the fiber ID, cable ID, and test point, because that will determine your file name. The file number will auto-increment by default. I will also leave file settings at defaults to auto-store results. Note that the file name will include the cable ID, fiber number, test point, and direction as configured in the prior menu. I'm now ready to test. I will press the start-stop button to start the test. The COSA will sweep the CWDM wavelength range, and after a few seconds, test results are shown in both graphical and tabular formats. The graph shows signal level across the CWDM spectrum. I can expand the graph and table with the trace table soft key. In the table, I can view channel numbers, wavelengths, channel spacing, and peak channel power. I can easily verify that every expected wavelength or channel is there, there are no unexpected wavelengths present, and power levels are within the specifications of the network equipment manufacturer. If I had set channel alarms, results would be color-coded red or green. The trace file has been automatically named and saved to the folder that is currently selected in the File Explorer. I can press the File button to browse stored files or copy and paste them to a USB flash drive. That concludes my demonstration of the COSA 4055 CWDM optical channel checker.